Hello everybody. Often I still get asked a lot of questions about visual prediction VB2. It is just kind of visual prediction that I prefer. It's nothing special. I publish enough information for free. Somebody who wants to understand can understand it. At roulettepredictionvb2 forum, we have private sections like for visual prediction VB2. It's all people who's got my roulette FF computer have access, plus some other people, plus many people who ask me. When I see somebody is serious about roulette, I just give him access to VB2 section. But sometimes people still ask me many questions, they want to know more. I can see they are very much confused, and the biggest problem I see people often, why 1.2 seconds time? There is no 1.2 seconds time. Time can be any, usually is 1.2, can be even less, can be, but mostly is depends from casino to casino, the kind of wheels they use. Mostly what I see around is 1.8 to even 2.2 seconds. But then another question, how to adjust the reference time for visual to prediction? There is equation that I published, but of course for that you need to see the video and take time in some ball rotations. But the easiest step is simply apply the time, then instantly apply the time again and see the difference. If it gives you same number, then you know your time is all right. If it gives you very different number, then time is not okay. For VB2, visual prediction to predict roulette outcome numbers, it's based on physics. You can count time if you are a good timer, like some people I know, they are musicians, they are extremely good in timing. I did few times, but the best is if you have a timer like FF Zap or FFV roulette computers have built in menu 5. You select timer, you adjust time, and that's constant. You don't need to worry, are you tired, are you counting slower or faster? But of course that involves gadget with you, and some people don't like that. And of course it's cost money. So how to adjust time, I briefly explained. Actually, for somebody who is interesting and watching this video, he still can have my roulette visual prediction VB2 access to forum. Just contact me, and I made here on myroulette.com shop where all computers there, it says donations. With any amount donated to support our service, you will get access to the forums VB2 section at. So there is no, I'm not after money for that, but just some appreciation. There is no limit or something. 1 cent, 5 cents, $1, $10, $100, $1,000, it doesn't matter. Same. Respect. So I'm gonna close this site. And then I have here prepared video spin and some data I took from the spin because I want to explain how to adjust time. Even this video is not the best example for the VB2. It all depends on the video, how the ball deaccelerates. This is actually numbers here, and here are same numbers or close range. So it's actually, this will work well within like four rotations, and this is from another spin. You can see same 32, 15, 15, 19, here already shifting to 34, 57. That's a slower ball. What's happening on roulette wheel, the ball deaccelerates, and the acceleration is constantly changing. And very earlier rotations, that acceleration is, I don't know, 12, let's say, can be 15, 11 pockets per second, while at late rotations is dropping 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, even 1. on the last rotation. So it's the acceleration on the wheel dropping. That's one of the problems that making prediction harder. It would be nice if it is like constant acceleration, but it is not. So we have only four rotations where we can predict with the VB2. I would like if it's maybe 6, 7, 8, like on some wheels, but for the explanation, this will do. So here I will first explain what will happen when if you adjust the wrong time. So here I have time. I don't know if you can see here. I'm not gonna play because I first time using this program. Zoom in or out. Here is 5,857 milliseconds in time of this video, and here is the ball. I'll move a little bit right, left and right. I don't know if you can see it, how it's moving. I go a little bit more. See, it's now it's here, and then I go tap 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 and come to that time. And the ball is above number 19, which for prediction it's totally irrelevant, but it might be relevant if you want to see the theory of VB2, why it works as it works, and I may explain it later. So let's apply here. I add, so I have that time here, and I add 1500 milliseconds. So that's meaning I adjust my timer to 1.5 seconds. And at this moment, when ball is say at this diamond, also don't get confused. You can do it at any diamond, any diamond. You getting reference number from this diamond, you will get different reference number. If that reference number doesn't match where the ball drops, you can shift a little bit and it may match. If it's staying a little bit shorter, you move this way. If it is, for example, your reference number is 0, but the ball drops at 29 and you started here, you can move here. That would adjust it so the next time, next pin, you get it right. So doesn't matter where you starting the time. I'm starting at 12, just it's somehow it's normal. I don't want to start here. You probably even don't see the ball. So we start the time, and then the ball moves and it comes to 59,757 in 1.5 seconds. So I'm gonna move the ball 59,757. 59, past it. 59, 8, 7, 5, 9. So the ball is at 21. So that's our reference number. And then if we apply time instantly after that, here we apply again the same time, we would, so we are now at 6. Okay, this is, I selected wrong here. That we can do one rotation later, then I will come to this number 6194. But it doesn't matter if I apply now. I have time 60026. That's this. So the next time I have to change this then. Actually, I go for one more rotation. Okay, I go one more easier. So now I start timer again. So I'm at 61127. I go a little bit back. 6194. So that's that time, a little bit earlier, but it doesn't matter. I cannot, if I move one more, it's a little bit too much. If I move one back, so it's somewhere there. So now we'll apply 1.5 seconds and we go to 6,2694. So 6,2694. knight 6-2, 6-2, 6-95. So you see the ball a little bit passing. I think it was 21. So it's the ball a little bit passing and it's coming to 34. So time is not bad. Still would work. You would miss few pockets. Depends in which rotation you're predicting. Usually we're targeting one particular rotation when we feel the speed is right. Sometimes we are one rotation earlier, sometimes we are one rotation later. And that was this was like two rotations later, and we have shift of let's say 1, 2, 3, 4 pockets. So we are not perfect, but it's still supposed to give us advantage. So, but the next, if we can adjust time better, it's of course is better. We want to reduce errors to minimum as we can. So if I go here, that's okay, let's go back. 57, 58, 157. I go back. So we are at start, 58, 157. And now we're gonna try 2 seconds time. So we are here, and we're gonna go to 60, 157. So we go here, 59, 60. So I have to go back a little bit. 159. 2 milliseconds difference, it doesn't matter. So we can see the ball is here between number 16 and 33. Okay. So now, so we're gonna wait, of course, until ball comes, because we want to apply timer again to see if our adjusted time matching. So when ball again comes here, a little bit back, same. That's a 6-194, like this time here, and then 2 seconds later it's 63-94. So we can go I want to show you something, it doesn't matter, first we go this. So we go 60, where I was, 61, so we go 63-94. I go slowly, I can jump quickly, but I'll go 63-94. Go back, 63, 96. We don't see ball, but if I move a little bit, we can see ball here. But ball, it's going in now, and that's where I am now, and that would be again somewhere here, the ball is. So 2 seconds time in this particular wheel, and this rotor speed would be all right. If rotor speed is faster, you would need more time. So with VB2, you play well, rotor speed is reasonably about same speed. It doesn't have to be exactly same, but say if it's like in between 4 and 5 seconds per rotation, that's fine. You adjust somewhere in the middle, and that's what makes only small difference. Of course, you have to make adjustments for rotor as well. So that's how you adjust the time. Now when we have adjusted correct time, let's go back. I'll go to where we started. That's 58, 157. 58, 157. Okay, so let's see in 2 seconds time how much the ball moves. We have here number 19, 857. Let's write here number 19. Well, oops, this now shifted. How do I go back? Let's move this one a little bit smaller so we can see. So the number 19. And in 2 seconds, so we go to, where is 58? 6157. Let's go again slow. So the ball is spinning. So we want to look how many rotations it makes. So one rotation, and then it goes more. And then 159. So it made two rotations and say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 pockets. Two rotations and 5 pockets. And our number 19, where it is, it moved from this diamond here. All right. So that's, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14 pockets about. Maybe 13 and a half. So let's go now to, where do we go? Let's say to this one, 6, 0, 0, 2, 6. So we need to go back. Okay. We go back. So actually, I think I was wrong. Yes. We need to look now how many pockets from this moment. The 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 pockets. The rotor moved. Now we're gonna apply from this moment 2 seconds. 6, 0, 0, 26, and then we go 6, 2, 26. So we go again slow to see how many rotations the ball makes. Takes one rotation, of course, and then a little bit more. 28. So the ball is here. Okay. So the ball made one rotation and 3/4 and a little bit more. But if you remember first time, the ball made 2 rotations, 5 pockets, was here. And if you look this distance, from this distance, it is the same distance as rotor moved. That's why Visual Prediction 2 locks the number. If you play traditional visual prediction, if you miss one rotation, you are wrong, say by 10 pockets or 8 or 9, depends how fast the rotor moves. If you move 2 rotations, you are wrong by 18 pockets. But with VB2, if you are wrong by one rotation, you miss nothing. Perhaps maybe some misadjustments in timing or in your judgment when you're observing, but you don't lose much, because this time compensates for rotor movement. And so before it was here, now it's here. So that's why VB2 works as it is designed for. So that's about it. You have theory and explained why actually it works. You have how to adjust time. If I apply to any from this time, you will see the same number. So we can try. Okay, just one more. 6, 1, 0, 94. So that would be Oh, I go a little bit back. Yeah, it's here. 610.94. And now if we apply 2 seconds, 6394. Six, 396. Where is the ball? Oh, it's coming here. I have to judge. It's coming here, and then it's coming. Tap, 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 tap. Okay, time is 162, and I need 96. So the ball goes back, and then that's one click, two clicks. So there is somewhere there. So you see the ball now made one and a half rotation, a little bit more. But if you look from previous time, that's about 1 second time. So that's what's how much rotor moved. And we didn't look the start number, but that's about it somewhere there. And before was here. That's in that 1 second how much rotor moved, relatively slow rotor. If we let this, actually I'll explain that as well, let this pin to the end. This one hits 12, but let's say if it's 6, because I was looking to 6 the diamond. We can look 12 as well, doesn't matter. But this would be, say, like close to ball drop somewhere here, and then predict it jumps there. It depends. I don't know what is the. This is actually not a tilted wheel. It hits in all diamonds, some more, some less. But all right, since it's hit 12, let's see what's happening. 12. So it hits the diamond at here. But we had a reference number pointing here. So to get prediction to this point, we would not start time here. We would start time somewhere here. And then we would get predicted our reference number would be 0. Depends if ball is still jumping, then we need something else. If from this point ball jumps, let's say was that like 20 pockets, we would, then it would be all right. So that's how you use VB2. You don't, it's very flexible. You can start it at any time to make it easier. Of course, you can always use diamond 12, then you get reference number, say 33, and then ball is mostly jumping from the 10 pockets, then you in the head at 10 pockets. But why to worry about adding extra, getting one number, then adding extra, just move your point like 10 pockets from previous one and you'll be adjusted. But of course there is more to it. Since rotor can change, so just to highlight here something very important about visual tool prediction. If you look numbers here, you have a 6026, then 1094. That's almost 1.1 second difference, and then that ball takes per rotation. If we look here, we have 6185, then we have here 7381, that's about 1.2 seconds and it's already start shifting. So the point you need to notice here, usually people believe later I predict I'm more accurate. With VB2 that's not the case. VB2 you can predict very early. That's also very good benefit of that kind of prediction. You don't have to wait like 4 or 5 rotations to the end, like traditional VB is maybe doing. You can predict 6-7 rotations to the end, because after the ball acceleration keeps reasonably constant until the ball is about 1.1. Depends on the wheel, but in general case, we can say when ball slows down, that is slower than 1 second per second. All right, if you go even a little bit more, you get from 15 to 34. Maybe you can get shift. Depends where you started and that's what is important to understand. Don't do it too late. Try to do when ball is faster and not too fast as well. Try to predict, say, like when it's 0.8 seconds, try to get that rotation, 0.9, and then apply. It depends what is your time. That if it's 0.9, you're coming to 1.1. If you want to move a little bit earlier, target that. The point here is, even if your time is not perfectly adjusted, if you miss by one rotation, you miss with traditional VB. If you miss by two rotations, if you misjudge, you by traditional VB, you miss, 7, 8, because it's predicting later in time, rotations are longer, you can miss like 20 pockets in two rotations if you miss by two rotations. Here, if you miss by two rotations, all right, if time is not adjusted perfectly, but it's still compensating, the ball is faster, okay, here maybe three rotations making same time, like in traditional VB, two rotations, but you're not gonna compensate for difference that rotor moved in that time. 20 pockets, maybe you will compensate for 16 or 15 pockets, so you are 5 pockets wrong. It's still better than be wrong by 20 pockets. If you can exactly judge when ball is particular rotation, then forget about it. So let's look now how to do rotor. I'll go back. I don't have to, but at the start where we maybe clock the rotor. So if I go, I'll just quickly explain how I do it. It's very simple, very simple. I'll go put zero somewhere. Okay. So rotor, let's say you start, of course, before all of this, you would start to time the rotor. Since you already have adjusted time to, of the timer or your count to 2 seconds for rotor, you can apply it once, or you can apply two times. You are a little bit more accurate if you apply two times, because you're observing rotor in 4 seconds. So if I look now, see it is 6:03, maybe it'll not be enough. I go a little bit more back. I don't know. In 4 seconds, ball not gonna drop. And the spin will still be all right. I can do it. So I need 6:03, 6:04, plus 4 seconds. 6:03, 162. I need 6:07, 162. 6:07, 166. Oh, I stopped perfectly. So this is how much rotor moved. Of course, you're not gonna count pockets. You're not gonna make stupid charts or something. What is important here to see, for rotor observation in this particular case, and if you're using two reference times, 4 seconds, rotor moves from, say, this diamond or this diamond, doesn't matter where you start clocking it. You can each spin do it differently, but you just remember the distance. If you start from this diamond, your expected diamond is this one. If I started from this one, my expected diamond that the rotor will be there, it's this one. So in this particular case, I see the zero stays one pocket shorter in my 4 seconds time. So instantly, I will make adjustment. It doesn't matter is it correct or wrong for the first few spins. That's the kind of trick. So what you do is, since your time is let's say until ball drops 12 seconds to 15 seconds. So you can say a little bit more than 12, but for easier calculation, let's say it is 12. Your reference time is 4 seconds. If ball in 4 seconds makes one pocket less to this diamond, in 12 seconds it will do it 3 times more. So you will need to adjust by 3 pockets. If you're predicting a little bit earlier than 12 seconds, you can adjust by 3.5, makes it a little bit harder to calculate, but you just 1 or 2 or 3 pockets more, whatever you want. So I would, so every spin before then I know even where the ball drops, I would just start, I would time the rotor, I see it's 1 pocket shorter from this one, I would start my timing little bit earlier by 3 pockets. So I would start it here. So instead of if I go back to 59, 25, 50, oops, it's coming here. 59 or 25, and ball is there, I would just start it. So I'm adjusted for the rotor. And now I just observe where the ball stops. If I apply here and the ball have a proper jump and stops here, then I don't need to do anything. It stops 9 pockets more. So I adjust for rotor, then I measure rotor. I say, okay, that's 3 pockets earlier. And then I add on that, let's say 9 pockets if ball is stopping 9 pockets from there. But let's say we can look the other spin. The other spin, I took timing here, I made some preparation. So that would be 62, I think. What did I do? Is that too much? Now same spin. Okay, so it started a new spin. Okay, I stopped rotor on this diamond. So the time is 23.649. I put here 23.649. And then I'm gonna, so that would be 27.649. That's 4 seconds later. So I start timing rotor here. Where are we? 27, it's passed. I have to go back. 6, 6, 5, 3, 6, 2, somewhere in between. So I'm here now. So my reference diamond that I dedicated like after 1/4 of rotation is here. So I have now number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 pockets shorter. So if I multiply 4 by 3, that's 12 pockets. Maybe a little bit more, I can add 15, say, the difference. So I wouldn't, this spin to predict, I wouldn't start this, but I would go, say, 15 pockets earlier because the rotor is lower and start here. So if I go to time, one of these, say, 25.051. Let's say 25. That's from diamond 12, but I say I want, because this rotor is lower, I would go 15 pockets. Just estimate 15 pockets somewhere. I cannot see it. Okay, you can see how ball is going there. So I would start timer now. And then I would somewhere here, 24650, so I need 26650, 26, 6, 6, 5, 19. So I have here, like predicted, number 5, and then if I let the spin go, then I observe how far, and then I always shift my reference point. Okay, it's this one dropped a diamond 9. It's not same diamond, this one and this one, and if it went to 9, then it would probably drop somewhere, hit somewhere here when it's about number 13. So this adjustment 15. If my valid point is 12, if it is not, then my from this diamond, that would be somewhere here I would start. So depends what I want. If I want the ball to be predicted a little bit more, I can move in one forward direction. If I want to be predicted less, I move in the other. I don't know what else to say. I hope this will help some people to understand the time is not 1.2 seconds, but that you have to define it and just practice it. I don't know who can watch this video, probably somebody who is interested in winning at roulette. Just forget about any mathematical systems, doubling bets or combining it. Only roulette advantage play can help you. It's based on physics, like roulette visual prediction or bias numbers. If there is some faults on the roulette wheel, but for some reason ball stops on some numbers, that requires thousands of spin data collection. Visual predictions like this, where actually you help to find better odds than money in 37 by predicting where actually the ball gonna drop. Of course, ball after that can jump, and many ordinary people have no idea. They say, oh, it jumps everywhere. No, it doesn't. I have here, I always invite people come to visit us at Roulette Place Forum. For example, we have a Kame Classic ball jumps. It's very predictable. So the ball from zero jumps mostly, say 5-6 pockets most of the time. Then we have a little bit more complicated ball jumps. Everything above blue lines will give you advantage, but here we can see 22 pockets, the stops. So even if you predict where the ball exactly gonna drop, ball can jump here, ball can jump here, but still most of the time here. If you play, if you reasonably well predict and play, you play this area, you can be a winner. Or we have another charts that I recently added. New data, it's a little bit different configured. Everything above green line is advantage. Here we see about 15 and 18. It's based by 3 pockets different because it's easier collection. 15 and 18 pockets we have advantage and 6. But we have here, you see here it's more. It is sorted by here is the most hits, where is wider area, and here that's actually what represents 15 and 20, and this is to just a different view. That's how the wheel looks like, and here it's how it jumps by different rotor speeds, but there is not enough data to be sure about that, but still we can see at rotor speeds, this is like in 7 pockets, a day pockets per second, around that range. The most hits were here. while here was only one. And so, of course, it is, casinos are aware of advantage players. They had the big shocks, people winning 50, 100,000, 100,000, over 1 million. And of course, they did something to stop it. They're introducing different wheel designs. They're introducing lighter balls that jump more, making things harder. But skilled player, or even if you just playing roulette and I assume losing regularly, sometimes winning, that makes you happy, you have no chance. But with some advantage techniques, you can have better chance and have more winnings. Thank you for watching. Visit us at RouletePlays.com. You can also look what is at MyRoulette.com. Once again, thank you to Donna for supplying video spins, any kind I want. And you can find my roulette videos at YouTube. There is plenty of videos to test. I think he's got some spins with more tilted wheel where you can practice visual prediction. Don't apply VB2 on leveled wheel where ball is hitting almost all diamonds. If hitting three diamonds, you can have still decent results. The best is one or two diamonds. That's about it. Thank you for watching.